Paul Ruiz, son of First Lieutenant Jose T. Ruiz, 12th Ordnance Company, Philippine Scouts. We remember all the Filipino soldiers who died while fighting in Bataan and while marching to their prison camp at Camp O'Donnell after they were forced to surrender in what is now known as the Bataan Death March. May they all rest in peace. Colonel Dan Furtado, U.S. Army Reserve Ambassador.
We remember all the American soldiers who died while fighting in Bataan, while marching to their prison camp at Camp O'Donnell, after they were forced to surrender in what is now known as the Bataan Death March. May they all rest in peace.
Raymond Canilao, son of Fidel Canilao, 42nd Infantry Regiment. We remember some 300 Filipino soldiers who, after their surrender, were massacred in April 12, 1942 in the Pampingan River in Bataan. May they all rest in peace. Chief Warrant Officer 4, retired Connie, Pizarro, United States Navy of Orion, Bataan. We remember for all Filipino men, women, and children of Bataan who became refugees during the Battle of Bataan, some of whom died before and after the fall of Bataan. May they all rest in peace.
Consul Paul McHugh, daughter of Santo Tomas University Civilian Prisoner of War, Alistair Hall, and niece of Alfred McMicking, Prisoner of War at Camp O'Donnell and Cabanatuan.
We remember the thousands of Filipinos, American and Allied soldiers, and civilians who died during their incarceration at Camp O'Donnell, Cabanatuan, Bilibid, Malaybalay, Palawan, Santo Tomas University, Los Baños, and other prison camps. May they all rest in peace.
Nancy Kragh, daughter of Major Clarence White, a doctor in the 31st Infantry Regiment who survived the Bataan Death March but died during the bombing of the Anura Maru on January 9, 1945 in Tikal, Formosa.
We remember the American prisoners of war who died in the hellship or Loco Maru on December 15, 1944 in Subic Bay, the Philippines, and in the hellship Enora Maru on January 9, 1945 in Tacao, Formosa. May they all rest in peace.
Jane Bosch Cambus, daughter of Czechoslovakian consulate trade representative John Bosch, who also survived the Bataan death march and died during the bombing of the Enora Maru on January 9, 1945 in Tacao, Formosa.
We remember the Czechoslovakian prisoners of war who died on the hellship Orioko Maru on December 15, 1944, in Subic Bay, Orange, and in the hellship Enora Maru on January 9, 1945, in Cacao, Formosa. They were all rest in peace.
George Retelas, grandson of Navy torpedo pilot George Retelas of Carrier Air Group 11. We remember the members of Air Group 11, Air Group 2, Air Group 17, and the USS Hornet, who were killed in action during World War II. May they all rest in peace. We remember over 126,000 Allied prisoners of war from the United States, Indonesia, Australia, Great Britain, the Netherlands, India, Philippines, China, Malaysia, the Czech Republic, Norway, and other countries who were transported in unmarked Japanese vessels, different labor camps between 1942 and 1945. Some 1,500 of the POW died from disease, starvation, and deplorable conditions in the ship. Some 21,000 POWs died from the friendly bombing of the hell ships. May they all rest in peace. Consul General of Mexico, Remedios.
We remember the Mexican Armados of the Fighter Squadron 201, named the Águilas Aztecas, who were killed in action during the liberation of the Philippines. May all rest in peace.
Junko, Fuchigami, Barreda, niece of Shoko, Imperial Japanese Navy.
We remember all the Japanese soldiers and civilians who died from the bombing of the hellship and all those who died during World War II in the Philippines and other countries in Asia, especially those who died in Tokyo, Hiroshima, Nagasaki, Okinawa, and the other part of Japan. May they all rest in peace.
Thelma Sevilla, daughter of Marcelino San Diego, of the 14th Colonel Serena Johnson, Garrison Commander, Parks Reserve Forces Training Command.
We remember all the soldiers and civilians who have died since World War II and for this very day as we speak in many parts of the world, including Ukraine. May they all rest in peace. Thank you so very much for being here today, 8 years after the fall of Bataan. So many sacrificed their lives during that time so that we here today can live in freedom. And I want to thank all of you for remembering, never forget their legacy. And 10 years ago, we did the first Bataan legacy event at Cal State. And here we are today, 10 years after. And 10 years after, actually, 2014, World War II in the Philippines is now being learned in California in the grade 11 U.S. history. Thanks to all of your dedication, and thank you for your belief in the cause. So I want to thank all of our esteemed guests. I will not name all of them, but you know who you are, but thank you so very much, and we hope to see you again next April, and we're also hoping to have a conference every year. We have a conference on World War II in the Philippines, and that's in September. We're not sure if we're going to have it via Zoom or webinar this year because of the COVID situation. But thank you so very much to our sponsors, VFW 8750-4618, Mrs. Consuelo Paul, Pure and Family, Ambassador Howard Leach, Brian Stinson, who want to honor all of them. And this event, by the way, is also dedicated to Roderick Hall, who passed away. He was one of our esteemed honorary board members. Connie and a friend, Ambassador Rocha, enabled the commemoration of the Battle of Manila in the Philippines since 1995. So, and Rod has made it possible to be here up on stage today. So, thank you so much.
Thank you. song going home, to be sung by Judith Javier Tew, accompanied on the guitar by Reverend Leonard Oakes of the Universal Choir. After the song, please stand for the retirement of colors by the Joint Service Coast Guard. We shall conclude the program with the casting of the wreath of the fantail. The wreath will be carried to the fantail by Senior Airman Adjutant San Jose, United States Air Force, Lieutenant Colonel Retired Edward Phillip, United States Army Reserve, and his father, Storekeeper Chief Petty Officer, Retired Arnau, United States Navy. Followed by Chaplain Santiago, Vice Admiral Michael Alistair, Raymond Canilao, Philippine Consul General Miguel Ferrer, and Mexican Consul General Remedios Gomez Arnau, and other guests. Upon reaching the fantail, we will have a final benediction by Captain Santiago Rodriguez, followed by the casting of the wreath and ending with TAP, to be played by Sergeant First Class Brian Williams, 6th of the 14th Regiment, 4th Brigade, 94th Training Division, United States Army Reserve. We ask that all of you pick up the flower on the way to the fantail and cast it into the water after TAPs. It's played to remember a loved one who served during World War II without their subsequent.
Thank you.